Dear contractors, dear colleagues, welcome to the wind farm project of Fécamp. After 2 years of engineering and manufacturing, we will enter into a new phase, the installation phase of the project. This is the second project in France. It will participate to the ecological transition. This is the first project for Normandy. And for us, we do want this project to be a success. And to be a success, that means no fatality, no accidents. And we rely on you in order to develop a safety behavior all of the duration of the installation. This is really our first objective. We do want everyone to go home at night in good health.
Health and safety is a top priority for the Fécamp project. That means that we want every worker to return home safely after his mission on the project.
Safety is everyone's responsibility. We expect everyone to be committed because we care about our people.
A lot of energy is being spent to build a common and open safety culture involving all stakeholders. And we have selected contractors who share the same value. And the offshore construction phase started with the offshore substation. DEME installed the pile in March 2022, and then will continue from summer 2022 with the installation of the jacket on top of the piles and the topside on top of the jacket. And then Chantier d'Atlantique, ENGIE, will continue with the commissioning of the topside up to 2023. From the moment the offshore substation is safely installed, RTE, as the French transmission system operator, will transfer and connect both export cables, which are used to export the electricity produced on site to shore. In parallel, Bouygues is currently finishing the construction of the gravity-based foundations in Le Havre, where up to 1,000 workers have been mobilized, and Saipem and Boskalis will come on site from summer 2022. Boskalis for the stoneworks, the preparation of the bedding layer, the scoring protection, the ballasting of the foundations, and Saipem will do the lifting and landing of the foundations. Prysmian will come later in 2022 to install the inter-array cables in between the foundations and up to the offshore substations. And eventually Siemens Gamesa will be the last contractor to mobilize in 2023 to install the turbines on top of the foundations. The HSE risks on the construction phase are numerous. Typical risks involve sea conditions, working at height, coactivities, and electrical power.
Additional HSE risks associated with the project within the wind farm industry are linked to crew transfer, lifting operation, work at height, manual handling, and work in energized system.
Over time, with routine, we tend to repeat unsafe behaviors. Some unsafe behaviors are not seen as risk anymore, because we have repeated them many, many times, and no accident has happened. This is when we become complacent. But we should remember, the more we repeat an unsafe behavior, the more we risk an accident. It is important to maintain a focus on safety, to remain vigilant, care for each other, and apply HSE standards and procedures. Everyone is responsible for their safety and safety of others.
It is key for the success and safety of the project that all personnel involved in the construction are familiar with installation procedures and associated risk assessments. This is reflected in our safety charter, which defines our ambition, zero harm, and how do we get there? Through leadership, involvement of all, and open communication.
We can highlight three main commitments. One of them is the leadership in terms of HSE, asking everyone to be example to reduce the risk in all the activities we are performing, linked to the stop work authorities, and the everyone's commitment into HSE.
Our life-saving rules have been defined based on industrial best practice and our risk profile. They address our life-threatening or life-altering risks. As such, their respect is non-negotiable. They must be followed by all, at all times. Always wear the right personal protection equipment, also known as PPE. Only work on machines that are isolated from all energy sources. Always keep a safe distance from moving equipment. Never walk or stop beneath a suspended load. Protect yourself from fall at height and protect others from falling objects. Never enter a confined space without a permit, an atmosphere check, and supervision. Always wear a life jacket when working near water without collective protection in place. Always wear a seatbelt and follow the speed limit. Never use mobile phone while driving. Never work or drive under the influence of alcohol or drugs.
One key principle to achieve our ambition is the stop work policy. It gives you the right, in fact the duty, to stop an activity whenever you see something unsafe or are not comfortable with the safety of your task. My commitment as part of the project management team is that we will back you up if you need to interrupt an activity.
Our stop work authority is one of our main pillars. Anyone at any level has the duty to intervene when facing an unsafe situation and to stop the activity, and will never be blamed for that. If you see something, say and do something. As a professional, you know your job. But as said earlier, with the time and the routine, the risk of perception is getting lower. For that, we are asking you to respect the latest documentation such as method statement and risk assessment. Now, let's focus on how we protect the environment. We are putting a lot of measures to protect the environment we are operating in. During the construction phase, we coordinate the different activities with the involvement of the Marine Coordination Department. They provide permit to work to allow access to the wind farm after approving the documentation. To work in a safe environment, you must follow the life-saving rules, apply the stop work authority, report any unsafe situation and positive observation, and know where to find method statement and risk assessment in link with your activity.
Within the offshore wind farm, to only stay on vessels, training such as bossiette is required. For vessel transfer to assets, training such as GWO is required. An offshore medical visit should be passed. During site visit or daily work in the office, you have the right to know, the right to participate, the right to intervene, the right to refuse, but also the right to disconnect. And remember, it's better to be safe than sorry.
Plan your work and work your plan, because if you fail to plan, you plan to fail.
HSC documentations are available through the Nest Point system and within the HSC department.
For us, safety is the first priority, and we rely on you in order to develop this safety culture. Be vigilant and good luck for the project.